Right, ladies and gentlemen, another beginner DJ lesson on training those ears for matching those goddamn beats. All right, so the tune I'm using is house music. It's by For The People. It's from Hospital Records. Now, the crazy thing is, normally Hospital Records is associated with D&B, but they are starting to bring out a bit of Four To The Floor. So big kudos to them. I'm using Record Box. I'm also using the Pioneer DJ Opus Quad, and this video is for beginner DJs. So on my right hand side, I have got the same track as my left hand side. The right hand side, I've got the reset button press. It's just off screen, but that makes sure that the track is at exactly the right speed. In other words, whatever speed it was made in the studio, that is the speed it will play at. So let's press play. Okay, let's jump a bit forward as well. Nice sort of soulful disco-y vibe to this tune. Don't forget, there will be a link in the description to Hospital Records. Okay, now if you're having issues with beat matching, this is a great way of practicing. You don't need any headphones, nothing like that at all. So I'll explain my setup. Right hand side is at the correct speed. Left hand side, I haven't got the reset button pressed. Right hand side, 126 BPM. You'll notice left hand side, 125.8 BPM. Let's slow it down a little bit more. 125.4. So of course, the left-hand side is slower than the right. So if I press them both together, bearing in mind now, I have a mirror image on both sides, except for the fact that the left-hand side is slightly slower. Let's press play on both of them at the same time and see what it sounds like. There's that phasing. Slowly changing to a double tap, a bit of an echo, and of course over time that echo is going to get worse because this is slower than the other one. Again, using my analogy of two cars, Audi on the right hand side, BMW on the left, they both start at the same time, but the Audi is going 126 miles an hour. The BMW is going at 125.4 miles an hour. Even though there's only a slight difference, over time, you will start to see that the Audi has covered more ground over time than the BMW. So using this technique, it's a great way of practicing beat matching skills. Demonstrate first, then I'll explain what I was doing. Okay, so basically what I was doing, it's almost as though, let's go back to the analogy of the two cars. The right hand side, the Audi has got cruise control on. So with cruise control, it will stay at that speed, 126. Whereas the BMW, you're having to use your foot. And what that means is that, let's say you take your foot off the gas, it's going to slow down. So of course, the only way of keeping up is to feather your foot to make sure you're at the same speed. So my feathering of foot in essence, is the movement of the jog wheel. Now, I'm having to jog constantly to keep in time with the other side. Now, it may seem a bit monotonous. It may take a little bit of getting used to. But over time, what you'll find is it starts to get easy and you start to get into a natural way of being able to work out if the track is faster or slower. There is slightly more in-depth ways of doing this, which I can demonstrate in future videos. But of course, the idea is to try and keep that phasing sound, because when you get that phasing sound, guaranteed the two are in beat. And of course, as the phasing sound changes frequency, you will know that, of course, the track is starting to get off beat. Hope that's a help. Don't forget, leave a comment. Thank you for watching. Practice and enjoy.